Hello friends, welcome back. Hearty welcome to you. In this session, we will look into introduction to calculus and try to understand at a high level what is differentiation, what is integration with a simple example. First, let's start what's the meaning of calculus. Calculus is branch of mathematics which deals with the problems related to change. What rate of change, to be specific. Now, what's the meaning of rate of change here is, if we have a function f of x and the domain changes from x to x plus delta x, then how the function will behave. That is what we are going to study as part of calculus, which is divided into two parts. The first part is called as differentiation. And second branch of calculus is nothing but integration, which are related to each other by a theorem, which says fundamental theorem of calculus, which says that differentiation and integration are related by the theorem, which says that differentiation and integration are reverse to each other, inverse to each other. That means differentiation is anti-integration, or integration is nothing but anti-differentiation. We will look into that as we proceed and go through the sessions. You will appreciate actually what we are talking about. For now, let's try to understand what's the differentiation and what is integration at very high level. Now, we are saying that calculus is nothing but the problem relating to the problems of the rate of change of the function with respect to the change in domain values. That means x is changing from x to delta x. And remember, we are talking about very, very small infinitesimal changes here with respect to the calculus. So whenever the x changes from x to x plus delta x, and then automatically fx will be changing from f of x to f of x plus delta x. Now, leveraging that, what information we can get more, or what we can obtain, that is what we are going to study as part of calculus. So the differentiation is branch of calculus where we study about derivatives. Now, what's the meaning of derivative? Derivative is nothing but, as we are saying, the change in the function, with respect to the change in the domain, the ratio is called as derivative, as the change is tending towards zero, or the change is so minimal that it is not equal to zero, but it is almost equal to zero. At that time, if we are able to find out the change in the function value divided by the change in the domain value is nothing but, as delta x tends to zero, is called as derivative, and the study of derivative is nothing but differentiation. So differentiation is identified with finding out the slope of a line, or if you have a function, if you graph it and you see that it's a curve, by differentiating or by finding out the derivative, you can find out the slope of the tangent to the curve at a particular point. Not only that, differentiation will help you to find out the instantaneous velocity if you know the distance and time, distance covered in specific time at a different time schedule. You can find out the velocity, instantaneous velocity, by differentiation. Let's come to integration now. Integration is inverse of differentiation. So integration is where we integrate the values and we try to accumulate the quantities and we try to find out the area of the curve. If we have a function, if you graph the function as a curve, the area of the curve between two points we are able to find out, then we call it as integration. To be simplifying it, if you know the derivative, we call the derivative of f of x is f dash x. If I know the derivative, then I take the derivative and I arrive at function back, that is called as integration. If I take the function and I arrive at the derivative, this is called differentiation. So taking the function and arriving at the derivative is differentiation. Taking the derivative and applying antiderivative or integral to calculate again to get back to the function is called as integration. Now let's take a simple example to understand the concept of differentiation and integration in detail. Very very simple example. So let's look at the example now. Let us take a very familiar and very famous example of distance, speed and time. Let us say that if you know the distance, you can see that this is the distance time graph here, and you have here velocity time graph. So if you know the distance, you want to calculate the velocity, instantaneous velocity at a time, that's a differentiation. You know the velocity at a time and you want to calculate the distance back, that is called as integration. Let's take a simple example and see that. Let us say that first I will try to take a simple function for distance. I will say distance is a function of time, f of t. So I will say distance is equal to 20 into t. Now what this tells you? S equal to 20 into t is nothing but y equal to mx. So we know that this is nothing but a straight line. So let us try to plot this line and see how this looks like. So let us say t equal to 1, s equal to 20 into 1, 20. If t equal to 2, s equal to 40. If t equal to 3, s equal to 60. If t equal to 4, s equal to 80. So we have a straight line. We have a straight line, you can see that. So S equal to 20 into T gives me a line. Now we know the distance, we want to find out the velocity at any particular instant. We know that since it is a straight line, we can easily find out the velocity by nothing but difference in distance covered, or can I say DS, divided by difference in the time. So that's nothing but, you can also see that if this is an equation of y equal to mx in coordinate geometry, you can see that m is nothing but the slope. So we can find out in another way also. Velocity is nothing but the change in the distance. Suppose let us say I have taken this point which is nothing but going towards, let us say, 4, that is 4. Now we can see that after 4 seconds the distance covered is 80 minus 0 divided by time is nothing but 4 minus 0, that's equal to 20 meters per second. And also you can see that that's nothing but slope of the line. So this is important. The slope of the line is nothing but equal to the velocity. We are talking about very very theoretical, simple, practically impossible scenario where the velocity is constant and you are starting, immediately you pick up the velocity and maintain the same velocity, there is no acceleration. Okay, so we know that v equal to 20 meter per second. So that's how, by knowing the distance and time, we can calculate velocity. Now if you see here what we have done, we have done v equal to ds by dt, that is nothing but, can I say, s plus some, let us say that it's nothing but the difference between the distance divided by distance, difference between the time. So that's nothing but differentiation for a small change. We have taken an example here, but in the next session example you can see very clearly why we are talking about small changes or infinitesimal changes. For now, remember that if you know the distance and time, velocity can be calculated by differentiation. When you draw the straight line, linear line, the slope of the line is nothing but the velocity. So derivative in this case is nothing but equal to velocity. So if you have the distance and time, velocity equal to ds by dt. Now let's come back here. Now let us take that velocity 20 meter per second, and we want to, now this is two-way process, that's what fundamental theorem of calculus says, differentiate to integration, integration to differentiation. Okay, now let us say that integration we want to do. Now I want to calculate the distance covered in 4 seconds. Only thing I know is the velocity is constant at 20. So what I will do, I will take 1 and put 20, 2 it's 20, 3 it is 20, 4 it is 20. Now let me join that. Now you want to calculate the distance covered in 4 minutes. Distance covered in 4 minutes is nothing but equal to, you can see that is nothing but the area of the graph between the time t equal to 0 to t equal to 4, that's nothing but equal to 20 into 4, which is nothing but equal to 80 meters. So this is called as integration. So knowing the velocity going back to the distance is called as integration. Taking the distance and calculating velocity is called as differentiation. In the next session, we will look at an example where there is acceleration involved and the curve is not a straight line anymore. It's a parabola. Let us see in that case how to calculate from the distance instantaneous velocity. If you have instantaneous velocity, then how to calculate the distance back. To understand better about differentiation and integration, but at high level you can remember differentiation is nothing but to deal with derivative, which is nothing but slope of a line or slope of a tangent to the curve at a particular point, or also instantaneous velocity. If you know the velocity, how to calculate the distance again back, or if you know the slope of the curve or the tangent to the curve at a point, how to go back to the curve graph again, or how to go back to the function again, that is integration. We will cover more about that in the next session. Thanks for your time. Bye for now. See you again in the next session.